on 16 by 9.
Voila.
They call it Circus NASA.
Bruises and muscle soreness, blood or rips, it's all normal part of our days.
It's a Cirque du Soleil training ground. The weirdest, the wildest, and the best in the world. Do anything and everything for a chance to get to perform on this stage. Here's Carolyn Jarvis.
With 22 shows on stage around the world, Cirque du Soleil has become an international sensation. Born out of small-town Quebec with only 20 street performers, today more than 1,300 artists perform under the big top year-round. But arguably the largest production Cirque du Soleil puts on is the one behind the scenes, in its casting department. It is an intricate web of talent scouts, auditions, and an annual training camp at its headquarters in Montreal. For 4 months, we were granted unprecedented access into the world of casting a circus, and over the next hour, we're going to take you with us for a journey we call Getting Into Cirque. If you've ever stepped inside the world of Cirque du Soleil, you will know its mystic intoxication. A place where the imagination is in overdrive, where the circus meets the abstract, and where audiences clamor. $100 million people have taken in the experience, and as we learned, it's a performance as entrancing for those who watch it as it is for those who aspire to be a part of it.
Cirque is like the epitome of entertainment. Like, it's the top.
I think Cirque du Soleil, best of the best in the world.
I want it really bad, and it's one of my dreams.
Every year, that dream becomes one step closer for an elite group of athletes who arrive here. At Cirque's headquarters on the east side of Montreal. They call this place Circus NASA, a creative hub as otherworldly as a Cirque production. Shows are conceived here, costumes are hand-sewn, and careers are built.
You keep the focus.
We have 3 meals.
And this past summer, 28 athletes entered this building for the first time to begin 4 months of intensive training. Each of these athletes has already made it through a successful audition. Some have been scouted, others have spent years submitting demo reels. The training camp that lies ahead will be their final qualifying hurdle before being cast in a show. Among those hoping to make it, Trisha Wu, Andrew Price, and Justin Leprall.
I feel like it's not real still. I feel like I need to pinch myself.
Being in this part is almost like you made it.
How's your French?
I can say bonjour, je m'appelle Andrew, où est le banque?
Safety is number one priority around here.
They are all high-performance athletes. Andrew, a world champion from England. Trisha, a recent NCAA grad from the University of Nebraska. And Justin, a performer at Walt Disney World. Justin has been working for 9 years to be accepted after a disappointing first audition in Orlando.
I sent in like 20 demo, like DVDs, full-on DVDs. I sent it to my friends that were in Cirque, and they gave it to their coaches. I handed it off in person.
You sent in 20 DVDs?
But I gave it to everybody that I knew. That
you wanted this badly.
Yeah, of course.
Despite their years of training on traditional apparatus like high bar, pommel horse, and rings, what these athletes are about to learn is entirely new.
How's it fit?
Like a glove. It's very cozy.
New apparatus like Chinese poles, essentially pain-inducing steel beams they'll learn to climb up
and go,
using only friction and sheer muscle power. And Russian swing, a rocking pendulum that combines a powerful pusher with a high-flying aerialist. Their coach is Mitch Head.
Most of these athletes, I would say 9 times out of 10, have never done what they're about to do in their life. I usually talk about a window of error, and we need to get that as small as possible, especially with something like Russian swing. Russian swing, you only fall once.
And it's game over.
Pretty much, yeah.
Finding athletes of this caliber to fulfill Cirque's constant requirement for new performers is no small feat. That's why, behind the scenes, Cirque has the biggest casting department in the world. Scouts in 8 different disciplines scour the globe, looking for gymnasts, singers, dancers, actors, talented enough to make it onto a Cirque stage. And they see everything. In effect, the company operates like its own agency, compiling a roster of talent to draw from at any moment. When you go to a Cirque audition, the prize at the end is not being cast in a show, it's making it into Cirque's databank of talent.
We will look anywhere we need to look to find the most exciting, best technically, best innovation, whatever it is, all over the world.
More than half of all Cirque performers come from a sport background. And that's where scout Stacy Clark comes in.
Who do you have here?
Yeah, I have 2 guys, Alex Buscaglia and Ryan Lieberman.
Today, Stacy is in St. Paul, Minnesota, meeting with gymnasts on their final day of training before the U.S. Nationals.
So you're making a run for 2012, huh? Yeah, good.
At this level, all the athletes here already have a high degree of technical skill. What Stacy is looking for is a certain sparkle, a performer.
I get a sense of how someone carries themselves, how they react to stress, how they handle themselves under pressure. You can see all that in an arena the same way that in the long term we'll see it on stage.
Well,
that's show.
Many of these athletes Stacy has been tracking for years.
I have notes like of people interesting, you know, great line, great extension, good look, all that kind of stuff. We're really, really conscious of not wanting to pluck athletes out of sport. They need to be done. It needs to be post-competitive. They need to be emotionally ready to put sport behind them.
But when they are ready, an audition will see them through to the next round of this lengthy application process. An audition that, fittingly this year, is being held in the city home to more Cirque du Soleil shows than any other, Las Vegas. Perform in a Cirque production in Las Vegas and you're signing up for an exhausting 476 shows a year.
Hello.
Sound enticing? Apparently it did to the dozens who lined up on a Saturday morning for a shot at getting in.
What's up?
A little nervous, but more excited than anything. Yeah, all right, it's gonna be a good day. It's gonna be a good day. I'm in Vegas anyway, you know?
I'm super excited. I'm pumped. I can't wait. Oh, you can't stop smiling.
Okay. I'm always like,
thank you.
Thank you.
Have fun.
Yes, indeed.
They've come from all over, Japan, Mexico, Belgium, England, and across North America, all to make it into that golden data bank of talent, and hopefully one day into general training.
I'm Stacy. I'm an acrobatic talent scout out of the Montreal office.
The standards for making it are steep. But the only problem when you set the bar this high is a lot falls short.
Is cut.
By the end of day one,
gather up, please, right in front here.
A pack emerges.
Number 8, number 12.
Among them, Niels Valkenborg, 3-time national champion.
I've come from Hasselt, Belgium. It's like 80 kilometers from Brussels. I've flown 19 hours to get to Las Vegas. And this is just like, this is already a reward. Getting here, trying out, and then hearing that I'm through to the next round, that's again a gift.
Elijah Holt, a powerful all-around athlete from Texas, has also caught Stacy's attention. As well as Austin Ray. But while Austin makes it through the first day, his knee braces flag a serious concern for the scouts.
I'll tell you, quite honestly, you probably would not pass the medical.
Really?
Now, I'm not going to make that judgment now. That's not mine to make. But you do need to have that awareness that we have an extremely stringent medical process that every single artist coming through our doors needs to pass.
Right.
It's our job to bring in people who can sustain 10 shows a week.
What's going on? Good morning, good morning.
On day 2, Austin returns knee brace free. But there's another obstacle waiting. And it has nothing to do with gymnastics.
6, 7, 1, 2, 3, 4. It's like getting water from a stone. I know.
You got the whole thing down?
No,
we'll get it.
We'll try.
We'll get it.
Because Cirque isn't simply a showcase in sport, athletes are required to show their flair, their acting skills,
a little faster,
their dance ability. It's the part of the audition process where some will be saved and others will end their day.
I haven't danced. I've never danced before, and it really hurt me. So it's a major disappointment, especially coming all the way out here and, you know, getting so far.
For Austin, his dancing isn't enough.
Hey, well, it's always next year, right?
At the end of 2 days, 13 people leave the City of Entertainment with a piece of paper, their entry into that data bank of talent, and a chance at one day being on stage.
Aha, dude, that's so dope.
I'm so relieved. In the beginning, I was like so nervous. I was like, and I finally started relaxing, and like, it made everything so much easier.
And I guess they'll call me in the future for what are the shows they want to do. Hey, merci.
I'm
really, really glad. It hasn't quite sunk in yet all the way, but just, yeah, happy all the way.
Next on 16 by 9, pain.
Bruises and muscle soreness.
For circus gain.
Thank you. training camp at Cirque du Soleil headquarters, this is the face of week three.
Pain?
Embrace the pain, everyone. It only gets better.
It's the new reality for our three gymnasts, Justin, Trisha, and Andrew, who have left the world of sport for a chance at joining the circus. It's coach Mitch Head's job to ease them through that transition.
Fast as you can go. It's a race. And go.
Week three is when the adrenaline starts to kind of wear off a bit. They start to really feel the fatigue from the previous weeks.
Good. Again. Next group. And go.
The pain needs no more explanation than a quick glance at what they're doing. Take this move, called the Superman, that takes near superhuman strength to pull off.
Just wrap your arm around, and your whole body is just hanging off of your, like, pressing against it. Yeah. And this guy can go, he doesn't even hold his other hand, he just goes straight. And it looks fantastic. It doesn't make sense when you look at it. You watch and you, how is this happening?
But the toll goes beyond fatigue.
This one feels the worst because it's just opening up again.
Their bodies are taking a beating.
Bruises and muscle soreness, and, you know, blood or rips, it's all normal part of our days, and it just kind of, you just have to keep going. And it's so hard to explain that to someone back home.
So, what do they say to people back home?
I say, I'm in banking. No, normally I just say, you probably won't believe it, but I'm in the circus.
While the men are excelling in the early weeks, Justin, with his strength paying off on Chinese poles, and Andrew, fast-tracked on the Russian swing, it's the guys who are stumbling when it comes to this. Dance class.
Hey, don't forget, you know, you didn't come to Cirque du Soleil to become dancers.
They may not have come here to be dancers, but this class, like several others, is mandatory for anyone in Cirque's general training. The point is to gauge their coordination and skills and build the base to work from should they be cast in a show.
You guys have a lot of work to do.
5, 6, 7, stop!
You cannot be inhibited if you want to be a performer. I don't give a shit if you're the shyest person on earth. I don't give a flying shit. Let go! Now dance for me.
The fact of the matter is neither Justin, Trisha, nor Andrew has ever studied dance.
I see myself in the mirror and I'm like, you shouldn't be doing this.
And so fair to say, hanging sideways on a pole is an easier task than this.
8, 7, 8, 10.
No, it's not right.
Yeah, it is.
No, it's not.
You know, but you're a counter.
8, 5, 6, 7.
I just made sure I had 5 coffees before to be ready for it. You just come in and it's like bang straight away. You're leaping around and you've got, yeah, Massimo screaming and swearing a lot, yeah.
Of course, there are professional dancers in Cirque du Soleil, but they too come from a specialized world with its own set of grueling standards. To find them, you have to go to a Cirque Dance Audition.
The main thing for you to do today is not to be what you think that we need to have or what we're looking for, but actually be what you are.
Of the hundreds who have shown up at this open audition in Montreal, only a handful will make it to the end and into Cirque's talent data bank.
Then you go 1, 2, 3, 4.
The man with their careers in his hands, Giulio Scatola, dance scout for Cirque du Soleil.
We're looking for the pearls of the world. We're looking for the diamonds in the rough.
Giulio's team will look at hundreds of dancers every year, and so the slightest millimeter in a hand position or extension can make the difference between a yes and a no.
All right, here we go. Showtime.
Before him, eager, young, limber dancers.
Reach up, reach up, reach up.
moving seemingly effortlessly through intricate choreography, all trying to impress.
There are a ton of people. I have no idea. I just went out there and did my best, and we'll see.
Sometimes even the most unthinkable moves still aren't enough.
We're going for the dancers that fit the closest to the profile that we need now or in the near future.
16.
In only a matter of hours, there will be a series of cuts, quick and precise.
So we start with the number 9, Paul. Nina, 29. C'est bien. Brittany, 31. Guillermo, 13. Christopher, 15.
I'm a little, I'm obviously upset, but there's always next year or another audition that I can come to for Cirque, so I'm gonna try again and keep training.
Come day 2, hundreds are down to only 30.
All right, should we start? Here we go.
They get the chance to try out some original choreography from Cirque's production of the Beatles' Love.
Here we go.
Intricate, incredibly fast, and leaving no margin for error.
Go ahead, go ahead, go ahead, go.
Keep in mind, dancers normally do all of this for a job. This is merely a chance at a job and getting into that golden data bank.
That list is a very coveted space to be, I think. It is long, but everyone on it is extremely, extremely talented. So you're in kind of Cirque's inner circle in a way. So it's an amazing place to be.
To get there, the demands are exceptional.
Okay. So I'm gonna ask you to do, if you can, in
underwear? All right.
The narrowing group is pushed even further, tested on acting.
Now one is Spider-Man and the other one is Batman.
And improv. At the end of 2 exhausting days of sweat and hope, a once crowded room is left with 4.
It's over. You're in.
Thank you, guys.
It says, you are now part of the Cirque du Soleil bank of potential performers for roles on our current shows and upcoming creations.
Hi, my name is Christian Denise. I come from Los Angeles, California.
Hi, I'm Jeff Wolf. I'm originally from Florida.
My name is Kira Jean Green.
It feels beautiful. It feels just amazing. It feels like all of my work has paid off.
Is it upside down? No.
Next on 16 by 9, a job audition like no other.
So I thought, what would be the most dangerous, outrageous thing that I could do?
When Trisha, Justin, and Andrew were handpicked for Cirque's training program, none of them thought it would mean this. Welcome to voice class.
Ein Aufnehmen.
another mandatory component of their training regime.
If you try and have fun and forget that you look like a complete idiot, it kind of helps a little bit.
It's difficult to let yourself look ridiculously stupid. But after a while, you're just like, all right, I don't care anymore.
It's all about making the transformation from competitive athlete to performer, the hardest part for most who come here. It's the fusion of those two worlds that makes them artists worthy of a Cirque stage.
So please, welcome everybody.
From voice and percussion, our trio moves on to acting. Today, they're putting on a mini performance to showcase their new skills. And Trisha has the starring role.
Oh my gosh, I feel as nervous as I would be for, as if I was at a competition for gymnastics.
3, 4.
While the training continues at Cirque headquarters, Cirque scouts are out looking for a different sort of talent. The type that goes to the roots of the circus, the clown.
I don't know what to say now. I'm just
hoping they'll make the cut, dozens of performers have shown up in downtown Toronto for Cirque's acting auditions. You only have to sit in on this audition for mere minutes to realize anything goes.
So I thought, what would be the most outrageous thing that I could do in a group audition situation where people would be? And that's what I came up with. Drinking my own urine and cutting, you know, Red Wolf in my body and standing naked with an ape head on.
The man sorting through the talent today is acting scout Marc-André Roy.
They have to touch the people by their emotion. They have to touch the people by their presence on stage. Patrick, he's got nothing for me now. For me, it's a cut for him, for this. Lorraine. No, she's too young. She's really green. She's a young clown. Yeah.
There are 120 roles within Cirque for actors and clowns, but this is a very different type of stage performance for an actor. There's no Shakespearean monologue. In fact, there are rarely any words. So performers have to be able to express themselves using only their body.
A high-level physical actor is someone that can touch an audience just by a movement. Just by changing expression of the eyes.
Two early standouts are Peter and Chris, a duo from Vancouver who were scouted at the Fringe Festival.
Said no. No thoughts that we'd ever go into a Cirque du Soleil audition, so zero clown experience.
No, we just have a lot of, we just like moving.
But only one will be good enough.
Chris is marvelous, the last one. Peter is less in his body. The people that will say, you're not staying with me this afternoon, but thank you very much.
Casting for Cirque goes against the grain of what most think of.
I'll be back.
In short, this isn't Hollywood.
Yeah, she's too gorgeous. She's too beautiful.
Actors cut because they are too pretty. Old, weathered character faces offering more appeal instead. Of the 1,000 people Marc-André looks at every year, he's lucky to find 30 who will make it. And once again, that simply means making it into that data bank of talent. At the end, five people remain. It could take weeks, or in some cases years, for a phone call to come for an actor to actually be cast in a show. But today, they are one step closer.
Oh my God, today I am a clown.
Next on 16 by 9, ever had to take a flying leap? Without a safety net?
Until they came here for circus training, Trisha, Andrew, and Justin had always been solo athletes. Now, learning how to be part of a team means learning how to trust. Like letting your partner whip you around from a steel pole, tethered only by their foot.
This is called the spin. And what we're having is a little issue with the porter. I'm trying to figure out whether it's the porter making the mistake or if it's the person being spun. She's swinging out too far and she's coming back and she's hitting the pole.
Do it again.
Coach Mitch Head flips the partners around to try to figure out why the girls are hitting the pole.
I see what you're doing that he's not, or actually what he's doing that you're not.
As she comes off the pole, you don't stand up right away. You let her come off, you crank her, and you stand up. She comes with him, she comes off the pole, but he stands up immediately, so that actually, what?
Swings her up.
Swings her up. Keep that knee bent, let her come off.
Everything that you can feel, you squeeze. Then you just stay tight and spin the hell out of her.
This is the end of week 6 of general training, and as the skill level ramps up, so too does the risk factor. Today, Trisha will be jumping off the Russian swing for the first time without a harness. No safety net, no bungee cord, just a landing she has to nail.
Today's the ladies' day.
And she makes it look effortless. While Andrew is still in the harness, he's exceeding expectations.
I feel confident and just need to nail that landing.
He's doing tricks off of Russian swing, which in my job training here, I've never had anyone do. So he's really setting the bar high.
The unsung hero of the group is the one who keeps the swing moving, the pusher. But don't be fooled by the simplicity of the name. This job requires equal parts brute force and intuition.
It's the little things that you get used to, just like pumping the swing with somebody on it, if they like the push at a certain time or not. It's quite difficult to learn everybody, but once you start getting used to it, you go into kind of like an autopilot.
In a matter of weeks, Trisha, Andrew, and Justin will find out who will receive a show contract and who will be left waiting. Still, being this close is a position of envy for many.
Hi.
How are you?
Pretty good.
Especially those who are lining up today for yet another audition. But this audition is one of the weirdest of all. They call it open sport because not even the scouts know what to expect.
I'm feeling pretty nervous right now. Nervous and excited and anxious. I call it nerve anxiousness.
I'm a wushu performer from England, so...
I came here yesterday from Korea.
Some years it's been sumo wrestlers and a unicycle basketball troupe. This year it's parkour, wushu, free running, and hand balancing.
All right, good morning, everybody.
Once again, Stacy Clark is scouting the talent.
I think all of you can afford to take your tops right off, please. We want to see lines.
Where this fits into a Cirque show, you might be wondering? Well, weaved into the choreography of six current productions, you'll find traditional martial arts, free running, parkour, and inline skating. It's easy for the scouts to see there is only one real standout. A wushu gold medalist, Sang Mook Oh, who has traveled all the way from Seoul to try out.
We have yes to 12 and no to 25.
The cuts are swift.
Yeah, one, two.
So at this point, we are making cuts.
Sang Mook Oh stays on. But the news isn't as good for Stefan Vickers, who also traveled quite a distance to be here.
We will not be keeping you at this time.
After a test of dance and acting ability,
good
the pack is narrowed to only two.
Yes.
An inline skater and wushu specialist Sang Mook Oh.
Congratulations, both of you guys. Well done. Very good.
For whom the long journey from Korea has paid off.
Thank you so much. Thank you. Thank you.
Next on 16 by 9, graduation.
That whole cliche dream come true.
Cirque style.
It's been 4 months since our athletes first entered this building to begin general training, and their evolution since then has been nothing short of remarkable. From putting on a harness for the very first time.
A lot of screaming the first time down.
To this. Both flyers on Russian swing, Trisha and Andrew, are now jumping without safety gear.
Just be strong.
A risky move that leaves no room for error.
What would you call yourself now? Are you an athlete? Are you an artist? Are you a performer?
I'm not an athlete anymore. I can say that. I guess I'd say I'm a performer in training.
Their abilities have changed, and so have their bodies. Andrew, much leaner, is down 6 pounds.
None of this is good.
Justin has gained 20 pounds of muscle. And Trisha has had to buy new clothes.
My shirts are tighter right around my arms and right here on my chest. These rings didn't fit before I came here. And
so even your fingers are bigger.
My fingers are little tiny sausages.
Today is a special day at Cirque headquarters. The athletes will put on a final performance with a proud coach, Mitch Head, looking on.
All right, preset, guys.
Well, today marks the end of the general training program, and this is what it all leads up to.
While there are nerves ahead of showtime, there is also an unspoken reality to what this day means. The athletes know that not everyone who arrives here at general training leaves with a contract.
If you are cast in a show, what will that feel like?
that whole cliche dream come true. I saw my first Cirque show when I was like 10. And from then on, it's like, how do I get into something like that?
Justin is one of two athletes vying for the same position in a show. And on the day of his final performance, he still hasn't heard. Trisha has even less news. No word if there's even a potential position out there for her. It's the harsh reality of training camp.
Right now, I'm still waiting to hear, so I don't know if I will get one. I don't even care if I don't get a contract right now or later, because this whole experience is unlike anything else.
It can come down to many different factors, just physical, personality. It's who fits a costume better.
But there is one athlete who is walking away with a guarantee of being in a Cirque show, our high-flying aerialist, Andrew.
I can't stop thinking about it. I'm so excited.
Andrew has been signed to the touring show Salt and Bonco and is slated to join the cast in March.
You said in our first interview that Cirque was the top.
Mm-hmm.
And you've made it.
Mm-hmm.
That must feel pretty incredible.
Yes, I feel so good.
But for those who are still waiting, today's final performance could help set them apart one last time.
Bienvenue à cette présentation finale de la formation générale 2011.
Of all their work. And for many here, a mere taste of what's to come. Of the 9 athletes who enter general training in the same class as Trisha, Justin, and Andrew, only 3 at the end of this show are walking away with a contract. But just as we were about to say a final farewell, a surprise. A visit from the senior advisor in artist training, looking for Justin.
It's to announce that you have a contract for Salt and Bonco. Really? You didn't know? You didn't know?
Oh, that's amazing.
Congratulations.
Thank you.
Wow.
Of the 2 candidates in training for one spot, Justin has been selected to join Cirque's production of Salt and Bonco.
Thank you.
How you feeling?
It's phenomenal.
You're on the verge of tears.
It's been 9 years since Justin first auditioned for Cirque du Soleil. 9 years that he's been working toward this.
Your life is about to change.
Yeah, drastically.
You will officially be in a Cirque du Soleil show. What a journey.
Yeah, it's been a hell of a ride so far.
He, like so many who come through this building, will very soon be able to experience the thrill of being on a Cirque stage. It's that thrill that every year has thousands of hopefuls lining up at auditions around the world and pushing themselves to the limit at training camp. All for a shot at running away with the circus.
Our show for this evening. For more scenes from Cirque du Soleil, head to our website at global16by9.com. I'm Carolyn Jarvis. From all of us here, thanks for watching and have a great weekend.